Did you just set up a brand new Wi-Fi 6 connection but is slowing down because your cousin keeps stealing it to watch prawn in 4K? What? He's a master Aquarius, ma. Or is your Wi-Fi keep lagging until mother cannot recognize and make you lose in Valorant, Apex Legends, LOL, Dota, and okay, fine, CS, go away. Today, I'm gonna explain something to you that might be the solution to all your network problems. Introducing the network switch. I'm gonna explain to you what this is and why you would need one in your home, in your office, and in your home office, technically. Shane, it's already 2021. Why are you still talking about network switches? Haven't you heard of Wi-Fi? Hold your keyboards, warriors. Yes, Wi-Fi has seen a massive improvement with the newest 802.11ax standard, also known as Wi-Fi 6, capable of theoretical speeds up to 9.6 gigabits per second. But there are still a lot of advantages of a fixed Ethernet connection that is capable of going up to 10 gigabits per second with 10GBE, but most of the consumer products are still limited to 2.5 gigabits per second or 2.5 GBE. If you're interested to find out more about the differences between Wi-Fi and Ethernet, as well as the differences between a modem, a router, and a switch, leave a comment down below so that we can make a video for you in the future. But here's the TLDR. Wi-Fi 6's maximum bandwidth per device is actually 1.2 gigabits per second and not 9.6 gigabits per second. Number two, the more devices you have connected to the Wi-Fi network, the slower it's going to be. So it's actually better for you to have more devices wired up so that your devices that can only use Wi-Fi will have a better Wi-Fi experience. Number three, Wi-Fi speeds drop as you move further away from your router or your access point, which could be a problem if you live in a 25,000 square feet mansion like me. Don't mention it. In number four, Wi-Fi introduces up to 100 milliseconds of latency, which could be a problem if you're trying to pwn someone in a game. In fact, they will probably pwn you, but not like you have a lot of game anyways. Okay, fine, Ethernet is better than Wi-Fi, but why network switches? To be honest, most of your wireless routers out there only have up to 4 Ethernet ports, and that might seem like a lot to some. If you're in an office or a production studio on a YouTube studio like ours, it's gonna fill up pretty quickly, which brings us to our topic of the day, network switches. First and foremost, what exactly is a network switch? A network switch is a device that operates at the data link level in a computer network, connecting devices using packet switching to enable full duplex communication. So full duplex means that the communication can go both ways at the same time. Basically, a network switch allows all your devices that are wired up to the same network to be able to talk to one another at the same time. Devices like your router, like your computer, like your TV, like your NAS, and all that good stuff. I can never understand how people can talk to one another at the same time. Every time I talk to Elaine and she keep talking back, I cannot understand what she's saying. Maybe the switch is smarter than me. Oi, how dare you, ah? A network switch usually sits here, in between your router and all your other devices. A network switch can come in many sizes. For instance, a tiny 5-port like this, a 12-port like this that is similar to the one that we are using here at Mob House, and even goes up to 48 ports. Not only do they allow your devices to talk to one another, they also connect them to the internet via an Ethernet connection. But hold on, what's the difference between internet and Ethernet? The internet is a global network that connects computers from all around the world, and it allows you to watch your prawn. While Ethernet refers to the most commonly used wired local area network, also known as LAN. This is an Ethernet cable, and this is what it looks like inside. It's so hot. That's what she said. Ugh. It allows electrical signals to pass through both ways, forming a connection that allows your devices to talk to one another. Another device that you might confuse a switch with is a hub, the older and dumber cousin to the switch. Essentially, in a hub, data from every device is sent out from every port, while a switch only sends out data to the device that asked for it. No wonder they call him Prawn Hub lah!
There are two different types of switches, managed switches and unmanaged switches. They can look almost identical, so do pay attention before you buy based on your requirements. In terms of features, the managed switch will have a lot more features. For instance, it has a console port and IP address which can be assigned and configured like this QSW-M12088C that we use here at our studio. A managed switch like this will also allow you to manage, configure and monitor the settings of your local area network for things such as control over the LAN traffic, adjust your channel priorities and generate virtual LANs to segregate the smaller groups of devices to enable better traffic management. Managed switches also offer redundancy features that duplicate and recover your data in the event of a device or network failure. On the other hand, an unmanaged switch is very simple in terms of feature set. It connects your Ethernet devices with a fixed configuration that enables no changes and is frequently used in smaller networks or as an add-on to larger networks. In terms of performance, the managed switch has priority SNMP, which allows you to remotely troubleshoot and fix your network. While the unmanaged switch is plug and play, no settings is required with the inbuilt QoS services. Moving on to security, a managed switch has very advanced security such as the ability to monitor and control your network to shut it down in case of active threats, a protection for data, control and also management plans, but it will require a technician to monitor and operate. While the unmanaged switch will offer you very basic security and is very simple to use. In terms of applications, the managed switch is mostly used in enterprise-sized businesses with larger network scopes, also data centers that need much better control over the network traffic, while the unmanaged switch is mostly used for small businesses, a home and also single office. Of course, the managed switch will be a lot more expensive than the unmanaged switch. Here are some scenarios where a network switch can come in handy. Number one, you have more wired devices than your router can support. Number two, you require a stable network connection from your devices to the internet because you need to send huge chunks of data into the internet, for instance, uploading huge 4K videos like what we do here at Mob House. Number three, you need a stable network connection between your computers or devices on the same network because you're constantly sending huge chunks of files from one device to another. Number four, you need fast write and read speeds for you to access your NAS and server. For instance, you're editing videos using your server or your NAS the way we do for some of our editors. Here are some of the things that you need to keep in mind when buying your first network switch. Number one, how many ports do you need? And that will be based on the number of devices that you actually want to hook up. For instance, the QSW-11055T only have 5 ports, while this QSW-12088C has 12 ports. Number 2, bandwidth specs, because not every Ethernet port is created the same. For instance, our QSW-M12088C has 4 10GBE SFP Plus ports and 8 10GBE SFP Plus or RJ45 combo ports, which gives you crazy fast transfer speeds for simultaneous multi-workstation access to larger files, which makes it ideal for video editing and multimedia. Something like this QSW-308S, on the other hand, has 3 10GBE SFP Plus ports and 8 gigabit ports, which makes it an affordable way to get into 10GBE for smaller setups without breaking the bank. Number 3, the form factor. Is it rack mountable or not? Now all of these QNAP switches that we showed you today comes included with a rack mount kit if you need it, or you can just set it up on any surface in your home or office just like that. Number 4, do you need a managed switch or not? I suggest that before you buy a switch, that you go to the manufacturer's website to make sure that the switch that you're buying is the right one or not, because they will definitely list it up on their website, like here in QNAP's website. And that is everything that you need to know about a network switch from a consumer standpoint. Huge shout out to QNAP for sending over all these switches for us to use as demonstration tools as we explain network switches to you guys. Do consider them the next time you are buying a network switch, because we have been using them in the studio for the past 2 years and they have been nothing short of excellent. Very good. I like it. Now it's time for the comment session that we haven't done in a while. So there's actually quite a lot of comments, especially because of the recent Elizabeth Tan collaboration. But before that, I want to thank all of you guys who actually supported my Make School a Safer Place video. Thank you guys very much. We should definitely keep at it and spread more awareness about this. So moving on to the next video. In our NZXT N7B550 motherboard review, Ya'en Lopper said, "Great job on this video, subscribe, highly entertaining and funny." Thank you, bro. Faiz Muhammad said, "Damn funny, good job. Why view so cheap?" Because we haven't been focusing on YouTube so much. But with your help, we can get more subscribers. Please share it out to all your friends. Corroy said, "Not recommended for competitive FPS games due to the Stormtrooper theme. I see what you did there." In our Lumos Aura Structural video, Hu Minchun said, "6,000 lumen, seems that it's gonna get hot," but he agreed with the brightness control. Yeah, I think it would be great if we can actually lower it down for a darker room so that we can, you know, save the lifespan on the bulb. But I don't think it works that bad, does it? I actually really wanted to respond to some of the comments from the Elizabeth Tan collaboration, but there is simply too many. So if you guys want us to actually respond to some of these comments, leave a comment down below and I might just make like a special video responding to your comments. How about that? If you thought this video is awesome, you know what to do, and don't forget to leave a comment down below if you have any questions about anything that I discussed with you today. And also don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell to see more content like this, and follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see more shenanigans from the Mob House crew. And I will see you in the next one.